Guy, what happened now? Why they wail like wailing well? You won't kill yourself?
Now mind you, now mind you, don't pull my hand. They draw their game and they don't cut my ticket be that. And only their game, now I can cut them. Chai!
So mind you cut your ticket, now you make you won't kill yourself. They go still pay you now.
How? You know, see, if one game cut ticket, everything don't spoil be that.
No, be Nairabet you they use.
No, I don't use Nairabet. Why you that?
You know, no, see, if you use Nairabet, one game cut your ticket, if you get past like 10 or more, they go still pay you now.
Guy, that's true, you the answer.
Just visit www.nairabet.com.
Wait, call him again.
When one game cut your ticket, Nairabet go still pay you. That's level, now one game cut. Just make sure say you accumulate up to 10 games, we get odds of 1.2 and above. If one game tear the ticket, he go still pay you. Nairabet.com, the caban of sport betting.
The AFCON is upon us. But there's one man who will be going there as the best player in Africa, an award won by many others, like, of course, our very own Nigerians, Victor Ekpeba, the late Rashidi Yekini, Kanu Wanko, Emmanuel Amunike, and, of course, in Ghana, Abedi Pele, when talking Kalusha Buaya in Zambia. And, of course, the highest winners, the likes of Samuel Etofis and Yaya Toure. And a North African carries his gong. Riyad Mahrez, undoubtedly, had to be the best from Africa. Shagun, you're welcome.
Yep. I guess he kind of broke a jinx or the motto, because it's been said that whoever wins the BBC African Footballer of the Year tends not to win, you know, the CAF.
That's true.
The CAF Player of the Year. But Mahrez did it.
And he did it.
Really happy. Also, that's after winning the Football Writers or Players Player of the Year in England in the Premier League. So fantastic achievement. And there's another term of reference or coincidence too is that all three players are going to be strutting their stuff in AFCON.
Yes, that's right.
Going for Gabon, the host Gabon. Sane is going to be there for Senegal. So we're going to see them, you know. But Mahrez, he's not really pulled up trees this year, set the world on fire, but for what he did with Leicester and the integral role he played, he set up a lot of goals for Vardy. Scored a lot of crucial goals himself.
As well.
Some screamers, I think, against City and you know, and everything.
No doubt he was excellent last season.
He excelled.
Aubameyang came second place and Mane third. Rightly so.
Rightly so, because Aubameyang, you have to remember, came second in the Bundesliga scoring charts Lewandowski. I think he grabbed 25 goals last season.
That's right.
I think he's up to 16 and he's leading the scoring charts in the Bundesliga. So, hey, he's an excellent footballer. But if you look, if you take in his club exploits into contention, then among the three, I think...
Had to be second.
It just had to be...
Liverpool's Mane in third position.
They got it.
He's been a very important player for Liverpool.
For both Southampton and Liverpool. They might miss him. Luckily, they have Coutinho coming back for them.
That's right.
And they have Firmino and Lallana. Adam Lallana is in the form of his life. So, but his explosiveness, his all action running, his willingness and ability to run the channels,
That's always right.
Trying to get beyond the fullbacks, is something that they're going to miss in Liverpool.
All right, so Mane there in third place. Of course, we must talk about our very own Asisat Adeshola, the Nairabet ambassador. It had to be a crown, but I personally don't think that Asisat was outstanding, especially, you know. She seemed to have dipped in form, but there was no one next to her. I mean, she won, of course, the Cup of Nations Nigeria as well.
I spoke to her when she came around to the, you know, to see Otumba Akinlab in his office. I had the good fortune to meet her and Onomaebi, two lovely young ladies. And speaking to her, I think she was played a bit out of position to accommodate the arsenal that the Super Falcons coach had at her disposal. So I think there was that lack of understanding between her and her, but she still scored six goals or something.
Yeah, six goals. She was a high school scorer.
She was a high school scorer. So yeah, she's a wonderful talent and she's only going to get better. You know, so, you know, kudos to her. And I'm happy that a Nigerian took away.
Yeah, it had to be her. She won. That jinx about the BBC Player of the Year, it's different on the women's side.
Mm.
I mean, she won it.
Yeah, she won it.
And she won the AFCON.
Yeah.
She won the FA Cup with Arsenal.
Yeah.
So it had to be her.
It had to be her, definitely.
It had to be her. Congratulations, Asisat.
Yeah.
Our very own Nairabet ambassador. We saw other awards going out there. as well, Dennis Onyango. Onyango of Uganda, Mamelodi Sundowns.
Superb goalkeeper, superb.
African player of the year.
Yeah.
Have we had a goalkeeper? Maybe just one from Cameroon. That's right. Be an African player of the year.
It's possible. Yeah.
That's right. So it's great. Uganda going to the Nations Cup.
And they're gonna surprise. They're in a tough group. I think Mali, Ghana.
That's right.
They're gonna surprise people.
Surprise team.
Yeah, surprise team. Dark horse.
We'll come to that when we're talking about the AFCON. The referee of the year was Bakari Papa Gassama. It seems to be his award. He's won it like three times.
Yeah, he's consistent.
Coach of the year, Pizzo Mosimane, Mamelodi Sundowns.
Brilliant achievement in Sundowns.
Brilliant achievement indeed. We hear he might just be asked to come resume as South African national team coach, but we'll see how that one goes. Alex Iwobi and Kelechi Iheanacho. Kelechi's own is quite, you know,
baffling.
It's wonderful.
Why would you be really
promising award?
For what? Promising of what?
He's been promising award. Yeah, no, most weird. Promising talent, Kelechi Iheanacho. Yeah. Won it 2 years ago. Won it last year. Winning it again this year.
He's already a talent, really, so you have to look at him. But Alex Iwobi.
He's playing first team.
Football.
Playing first team.
Yeah,
so next year he should be contending for the main awards.
Yeah, exactly.
And then Alex Iwobi, young player of the year.
No, breakout season in Arsenal. There are rumors that if Mesut Ozil doesn't sign a new contract, Iwobi is going to be the de facto number 10, you know, and in a team that is brimful of talent as Arsenal, with a lot of very, very skillful and creative midfielders. For Alex Iwobi to come through the ranks and break into the first team now, so that's a great achievement from the young lad. And break into the Super Eagles as well. And I still remember that both emerging talent and promising talent grabbed us a brace, a couple of goals in Ndola. So, hey, kudos to them.
All right, so can we say, since there was no Nigerian in the top list, these guys are the ones we should look forward to now? These are our best players in Nigeria.
Yes, they are, but
They are still young players and talents.
You know, because of the marked deficiencies of our football, and considering this is our second AFCON we're going to miss, obviously, the Super Eagles are not really going to rank high. You know, more mature, more established players are not going to. But this 2017, let's look forward to a bigger and better 2017. And considering that, I think CAF draws for the 2019 qualifiers will happen, I think, later this week, and then it'll start in June. So, you know, and the World Cup qualifiers back to back again. So, there's a chance for one of our Super Eagles to write his name, you know, on the trophy for next year.
And we certainly are looking forward to that. President Buhari won the CAF Platinum Award
somewhat bewilderingly. I think that's a political award.
Political. Because really, did he look at sports?
President
Muhammadu
Buhari has many qualities. Interest in sports doesn't strike me as one.
It doesn't.
So
certainly it doesn't.
I think that's political.
All right. So of course, congratulations to all the winners. Anyway.